Welcome to a video series on Python. Today we will learn about a data structure called as list in Python. Okay, so let's start. So to create a list, okay, all we need is a bracket, okay, and the name of the list. For example, let's create a list of cars. Now a list is a compound data structure. That means it can contain values or items inside it, which can be of type Boolean, numbers, string, or it can be mixed also. Okay, so here I'm going to create the names of my cars. Okay, like I'm going to store all the name of my cars in a list called as cars. So let's say BMW Merc Audi. So these are the name of my cars. So what did we just do? We created a list. Create a list. The name of the list is cars. Okay. Now, if I want to print the items in the list, what I can use is a print function. If I want to run this, so I just say the name of my file, so py space list dot py, right? And you can see the names getting printed on the screen. All right. What if I want to print using a for loop? Okay, so let's see if we like to use the for loop and print each element. Okay, so we can say for c in cars print. So it will iterate to the loop and print one item at a time. You see, BMW, Merc, and Audi. So how is the list stored? Okay, so when we store the items in the list, okay, the first index position, okay, so BMW is stored at the index position 0, the Merc at index position 1, and the Audi one after another. So the index position of the Audi is 2. Okay. Now, for example, so this is what we did, we just looped it, okay. So I'm just commenting this because I don't want this to be looped again and again. Okay. Now, for example, if I want to replace a value at a particular index position, okay, if I want to replace a value at a particular index position, for example, I want to say replace an item. Let's say an item. My value or an item is at a list. So at which position? So let's say I want to replace it at zeroth position. Okay, that is BMW. So let's say cars at position 0. You don't want BMW. You want Ferrari. Okay. So now when I print it, if I say print cars. The first value earlier it was BMW, now it is. Alright. So this is how you replace an element. Okay. Replace an item or an element or a value inside the list. Now we will see some methods, okay, that will work on the list. Okay. So few methods. The first method is called as append. Now what does append do? It adds an element to the end of the list. So it adds an element to the end of the list. For example, if I say cars dot append Jaguar. Okay. Now if I print my cars, it will append Jaguar at the very end. You see, Jaguar is added at the very end. Now someone would say, I don't want to add an element at the very end. Okay, he will say, I don't want to add an element at the very end. So he can use a method called as insert. Now what does insert do? Insert says, insert an item at a given position. So it inserts an item at a given position. Now for example, we have Ferrari at position 0, Merc at 1, Audi at 2, and Jaguar at 3. So I want to replace, I want to add an element at the position 3. So for example, at the place of Jaguar, I don't want to replace Jaguar, but I want to add another name of the car, and then I want to move Jaguar ahead. So for example, I'll do insert. Let's say cars dot insert. So insert position 3, and the name. So the name will be, for example, I want to say Suzuki. Okay. So now when we print this. Okay. So earlier it was Jaguar at position 3, now it is Suzuki. And what happened to Jaguar? It moved one step, one position. Okay. Now another method that we have, okay, that we can work on list is called as remove. Okay. Now what does remove do? It removes the first item from the list, okay, with the value that you give. Okay, so removes the item from the list. Okay. For example, I don't want to keep Audi in the list. Okay, so I'll say cars dot remove and pass the value which is Audi. Now, in such scenario, if you do a spelling mistake, for example, instead of A capital A, you say small a Audi, and in the list we have capital A, so it is case sensitive. So when we print it here, okay, if we say remove Audi and then we print the cars, it will give me an error because capital A, let's see the error. Okay. It says cars are removed. So we don't have the element that or the item that you're looking for. So we should change it to a capital. Alright, now see Audi is no more in the list. So we remove the element also. Now if I want to pop an element. Now what does pop do? We also have a method called as pop. Okay. Now what does pop do? It removes the item at the given position in the list. Okay. For example, when we say remove, okay, so we remove an element from the list, but now we say pop, okay, so it removes an item at a particular position. Okay. Now remember this, it removes an item from a particular position. We need to say the position of the item. For example, if I say cars dot pop, and pop what? So pop the position 0. We don't want to keep Ferrari, so it says pop 0. Okay, and we would like to print the result, so it returns the values. So whatever you're popping, it returns. So I'm storing it in a value in a variable called as result. So cars dot pop. Okay, and now if I print it. Oh, sorry. We don't want to print cars. We want to say we want to print the result. So what is there in the let's see, Ferrari is a value which is popped, that is removed from the cars. Okay, if we print cars now, sorry, I'm putting semicolon because other languages I use semicolon. In Python, we don't have semicolons, we don't use semicolon. Now, if you see, Ferrari is no more than in the list. So pop, what does pop do? Removes an item from a particular position. So you have to mention the position also. Alright. Now you also have a method called as count. Okay. Now what does count do? It gives you the number of times the item appears in the list. Okay. The count gives you the number of times the item appears in the list. So it gives you a count of number of times the item appears in the list. Alright. So when I say give me a count of Jaguar. Okay. So we say print. Okay. For example, now it should be cars dot count. How many times is Jaguar there? Okay. So we need to surround this completely with the. It will return a value to us, and we want to print this value. This method count on list will return a number on the print. Okay, say fine. Say now. So it says 0. Why is that 0? Is there a spelling mistake? Yes, the spelling mistake says Jaguar. Now it should give me 1. Okay. So if there is Jaguar twice in the list, it will give me 2. So if you want to sort the list, okay, you can say sorting the list. Okay. So we say, for example, we say cars dot sort, and now we print cars. Now what do we get? See, now it is sorted. Earlier it was Mercedes, Suzuki, and Jaguar. Now it has been sorted in ascending order. Okay. Now it has been sorted in ascending order. All right. So in this way, we can also delete the list. Okay. Or we can not just, we don't want to delete the list completely, but we just want to clear it. That means we want to remove all the elements. So when I say remove all the elements or items. Okay, note, I'm not saying that delete the list. I'm just saying remove all the elements. So we have a method called as clear. So it is a cars dot clear. Okay. This will clear all the elements in the, or it will clear all the items in the list called as cars. So print now. Print now, you give me an empty list. See, the list is empty. So still we did not delete the list. Okay, we have just cleared it. Okay. Now still I can add. Okay. Again add something. Let's see. Again add something. Now let's add by method which can be append. So we say cards dot append data. So we did not delete the list, we just cleared it. Now if you print it again, you will notice there's only one item in the list. But if I say delete, okay, del, what will it do? What we'll do? See, delete the cars, the list, and say car name is not different. It means the there's no way, there's no list called as car. So if you want to delete it, delete the list, then you use the keyword called as delete DL and then the name of the Alright, so go ahead, practice this data structure called as list. It is very important and it is used in many places when you work with Python. Okay. So I would like everybody to go ahead and practice this data structure and subscribe to our channel. We'll be posting a lot of videos, okay, on Python, and please share it with others, share it with your friends so that they can benefit from this video. Thanks for watching. I'm Amin Kazi from Visual Labs. Have a nice day.